Welcome back to all our ornamental fish with viewers. Thanks for joining us for this another insightful video on breeding, rearing, and caring for your ornamental fish. If you're new to our channel, please remember to click the subscribe button for instant notifications and more. Now, today we'll be diving into the fascinating process of breeding and hatching angelfish eggs, specifically using methylene blue to improve hatch rates. Want to know more? Stay tuned. Welcome back, all. Now, once your angelfish lay their eggs, you'll notice the male fertilizing them. These eggs are tiny and translucent with a slightly amber hue. It's critical to act quickly as angelfish parents sometimes eat their eggs, specifically if they feel stressed or threatened. You have two options which you can explore. You can leave the eggs with the parents. This is usually a risky option. Or you can carefully remove the eggs to a separate tank or a container for controlled hatching. But for best results, it's best if you set up a separate tank for the eggs. Use water from the main tank to maintain consistency in water parameters. Add an air stone near the eggs to ensure proper oxygenation and avoid strong currents that may dislodge them. Keep the water temperature consistent around 80 degrees Fahrenheit. Now, once you're going to be using methylene blue, you can add your methylene blue to the water. This methylene blue is a game changer when it comes on to preventing fungal infections on your eggs. And this is how you use it effectively. You are to add at least 1 to 2 drops of this methylene blue per gallon of water. Also, add the methylene blue immediately after transferring the eggs to the hatching tank. You are to observe and watch for the next 24 to 48 hours and to ensure that your eggs are okay. So your fertilized eggs will look and turn darker in color, while unfertilized eggs may turn white. Now, when you have set up your tank, your eggs are in your tank, the angelfish eggs, they usually take within 48 to 72 hours to hatch, depending on your water temperature. Now, once the eggs hatch, you'll see tiny wiggling looking fry attached to the spawning surface. These fries will absorb their yolk sacs for nourishment during the first couple days. As you can see here, this is one of my tanks that shows you my angelfish fries. They are still in a little methylene blue that has just become free swimming. So therefore, I would need to perform some small water change, and I'll continue to do this every day. And this is to maintain the water quality. And also, I would have to be extremely careful not to too disturb or disrupt the fries, as I would have to gradually reduce the methylene blue levels in the water. And this is done by replacing this methylene blue water with fresh water. Now, after about 5 to 7 days, the fry will become free swimming. This is another tank I have with some free swimming fries, and they have become free swimming a couple days ago, and I've started to feed them freshly hatched brine shrimp. Now, you can use finely crushed fry food if you don't have any brine shrimp, but you're to ensure that this frequent water change is gentle, and you ensure that you keep their environment clean and free of any toxins. Now, if you are going to be breeding these angelfish and caring for these youngs, you would also need to replace your ear stone with a sponge filter. Now, this filter will help you to control the amount of toxin in the water and also balance out and cultivate that natural water cycle that would see your fries thriving. Now, this is another tank with an older set of angelfishes that I have. They're about 6 weeks old. And these fries are the first set that I hatched out successfully, because as you go, there are times when your best efforts, you will end up losing an entire batch of angel fishes. So therefore, I have really started the process of really putting back angel fish in my tanks. So therefore, I've conditioned my parents to breed every 2 weeks to kind of have that system in place to ensure that I'll have angelfish consistently. Now, one of the drawbacks of really breeding angelfishes, as I said earlier, is that you will end up losing an entire batch based on your best efforts. Now, here you're looking on a set. I'm not certain if the male didn't really fertilize the eggs, but as you can see, all these eggs are spoiled. And I'll give you a closer look on these eggs as I'll be taking them out of the methylene blue. If you look closely, these eggs are white, they are opaque, and they are not transparent. So this entire set of eggs I've lost. So it could be that the male didn't fertilize these eggs properly. Now, this is one of the drawbacks in breeding angelfishes. Also, if you're not careful to pay close attention to your feeding, your water changes, and how you control the toxins in your tank, then you will end up with dead fries. It will prove fatal for your fries. So in breeding angelfish, and whenever you're dealing with these fishes, you have to pay close attention to your fries. And that's it in regards to breeding and hatching angelfish eggs. Now, this can be an incredibly rewarding experience, especially when using methylene blue to protect your clutch. Remember, patience and careful observation are key. If you found this video helpful, give it a thumbs up, share it with your fellow fish enthusiasts, and let us know in the comments section if you have tried breeding angelfish yourself. Thanks much for joining us for this another insightful video
from ornamental fish waste.
So until next time, see you and happy fish keeping.